Hello, good morning. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today, what I'm going to do is to continue or do my part 4 for this series tutorial on how to create a BMS graphics. Okay. Now, actually, offline, I did some changes in my graphics. In my part 3, what we have done is to create the snippets, okay? These snippets, the dynamic text and dynamic value. We have used dynamic text and dynamic value. Dynamic meaning it is constantly changing, okay? So when it is dynamic, it will change, the value will change. The text might change from, let's say, this one handled auto. It will change from manual to automatic or vice versa. It depends on the real scenario in the field. Okay, let's say someone put the motor control for these two pumps in manual, then it should be shown here automatically. Okay, so let's say pump one, you put it in manual or off, then you will be able to see the real-time value here. Okay, likewise for the start stop command, we are using here dynamic text, so this text will change based on the real value from the field. Okay. Now, okay, since last tutorial, I have done only for pump 1, then I continue with pump 2. The same procedure, so no need to show you how I did in pump 2. Now, what are the other things I put in my graphics? Okay, this one, the same, you know already. Now, I have put here, this one is a spinner, okay? Now, here, where did I took that spinner? Okay, so you will go to my components. Okay, so the spinner is here. So I'm just using this. Now decrease a value, or increase a value. So all you need to do is click and drag it in your graphics. Okay, so that's how I put it in my graphics. Okay, so it's very easy. Now here I put this water tank. So where did I took this? I took it from this bezel. Okay, so you see you have several bezel here. Okay, so I use this one. Tank 2, so you will just drag it, then try to resize it. Okay, so that we will later on, we will be having a animation for this. Okay, now this spinner, I will be using this for animating the water tank, water level. Okay, so I can increase and decrease the water level here, then we will see how our building management system will respond to it. Okay, so just a minute, I will just pause the record. Okay, now sorry for the interruption. Okay, now so you know already how I did these several changes in my graphics. These are the same. I'm using here a snippet, dynamic text, then dynamic value. I already show you how are we going to do, how are we going to include it in our graphic file. Okay, then the spinner, this is just, this one is will increase the value based on the object that you will bind it. Okay. Okay, so I put all this spinner so that we can play with the level of the water inside the tank so that we can simulate the operation of the solenoid valve and the pumps. Okay, now here the same thing, dynamic value and text. Now here for this water tank, okay, this one we will be using this for animating the level of the water inside the tank. Okay, so I took it from my components under what is this one. So let me show you this one. This is structure wear, building operation, vessel and tanks pressure units. Okay, so these are built in graphics library in this software. Okay, now today what I'm going to show you is how we are going to manipulate this dynamic text. Okay, so I have here my dynamic text. Make sure to select it. If you want to work on it, you have to select it. Okay, then as you can see here, if you will go to your object, it is already highlighted here. So that is P1 hand of auto status. Okay, so let me collapse it or expand. Now I have here a bind. Okay. Okay, I have here a bind. So my bind for this is the same as my object name, P1 handoff auto status. Okay. Now here, where you have, make sure you have to check that bind or select the bind. Okay, then you go to the properties. Okay, so this is the property window. Let me, okay. Now for the property window, you will be able to see the bind name. Okay, it's okay. Then the name, it's the same, no issue. You can use the same or you can use P1. But for me, I always use the same bind name and name, okay? Now the format should be presentation, okay? Then what is the target? Now the target attribute is the content, okay? So when you say target attribute that you are going to manipulate is the content. So what is the content of this object? Okay, the content of this object is the text manual. Okay, so this manual snippet is the target. Okay, so now what we need to do in order to give the real-time value of the point being monitored, we need to create a convert. So right-click, then we have to create a convert text. Okay, convert text, because we want to convert the text from auto to manual. Okay, now here go to the once you created the convert text, you will go to the properties, then again you can put the name here. Okay, I will say this is for my active. Okay, active, then behavior. What will be the behavior? Now the attribute value. Now if the point is active, when you say active, let's say the point is, let's say someone put it in automatic. So that is the active point, okay? So when the point is active, what will be the attribute value? Okay, I will say it will be auto, okay? So meaning, if someone put it in automatic, this dynamic text should display auto, okay? Or if the signal is one, so you will put here signal equals to one. What do you mean signal equals to one? Now, as you know, this pump handoff auto status, we are monitoring the selector switch in the control panel. Let's say pump one, selector switch, manual off, auto. Now, if someone put it in auto, then it says it's like we are having a signal of one, meaning the open or the normally open contact will close, then it will give us a signal one or on status or on signal. Okay, so the signal is equal to one. Okay, so when it is active, this snippet will change to auto or based on the signal that we receive, like one. Okay, now here I will create another convert text, new convert text. Okay, now this time I will name it as inactive. Okay, so during inactive, now, what will be the behavior of the attribute? It should be manual. Okay, then the signal will be equal to zero. Okay, so meaning the selector switch, when it is in automatic, someone put it in automatic, it will give us a signal one. Then the dynamic text should change to auto. Let's say someone wants to run this pump one in manual, you have to put it in manual. Okay, so he can run it in manual. So when you put it in manual, now the signal becomes zero or inactive. So when it is inactive or the signal is equal to zero, what will be the display text of this snippet? It should be manual, okay? So again, I will create another. Okay, what I will do, I will copy this, okay? I will copy. Then I need to paste it here. Okay, so I will paste it. Now again, I have created another bind, the same bind name, always the same bind name for the same point. Okay, now here I have to change my active. First, we need to change the target attribute. Before, the target attribute is the content. Okay, so from manual to auto. Now the attribute target here should be the stroke. Okay, stroke is for the color of the snippet or the color of the text. Now, because in automation or building management system, when it is active, you can change the color to, let's say, green. Okay, when it is inactive, you can select another color, let's say dark gray. Okay, so I will change. Okay, I already changed the attribute, the target attribute to stroke. Now I have to change the active signal. When it is one, what will be the color? Okay, so what will be the color? I will use this dark. Then when it is inactive, I will change this. Because I will select this one. So active, dark green, inactive, let's say it is dark gray, okay? Now the same thing I will do here in my pump one start stop command. Okay, let me expand it. Okay, this one. So what will be the content? Okay, now I think I can copy. Okay, let's me just do the long way. Okay, new again, convert text. Okay, so you will be get familiar to this. Convert text. Okay, now here again, I can say active. Then attribute. When it is active, I can say it should display on. Or meaning, when I started the pump, this snippet should show on status. Okay, signal equals to one, the same thing. Okay. Now again, go there in the bind, then new, convert text. Okay, now again, this one will be for my inactive. Inactive, okay, what will be the behavior? When it is inactive, it should display off, then the signal is equals to zero. Okay, now I will just copy this for my stroke attribute, okay? Now paste. Okay, because I don't want to keep on. Okay, where is it now? Let me. Where? I think I have done something wrong here. It should be here. Okay. Paste. Okay, so I'll put it there. Okay. Delete. Let me delete it first. Let me delete. I think I have done something wrong there. Okay. Now this one, okay, copy, then paste it here, paste, okay, now I think it's correct. Now here, let's change the active because, let's change first the stroke, I mean the target attribute, it should be the stroke. Okay, now when it is active, okay, again, I will use the dark green. Then when it is inactive, I will use the dark gray. I think this is the dark gray, okay. Now, let me do for the run status. Run status, okay, run status. Now here, I have a bind here, okay. Now, this is already for content. I will create a new convert text, okay. So the same procedure. What is this? Active. Okay, so what is this point? Run status. Okay, I can say the attribute should change to run, to on, or run. I will just use on. Then signal equals to one, the same. Okay, then here create another convert text. Okay, now this one is for inactive attribute. Okay, of signal zero. Okay, now here I will copy this so I can create a new bind, new paste. Okay, so this is now the new. Okay, now here the active, first let's change the attribute. Okay, so this one is for the stroke. Okay, when it is active, okay, I will be using the same inactive. Okay, so when you are designing your graphic, you should do it professional looking. Okay, so when you are using active green for some of the monitoring points, then you have to use for all the monitoring points. Okay, so that it will look good. Okay, now here I have already this one, so I can do for this strip. Now this strip, this is different thing. Okay, we will come here. Now here, okay, then I will, okay, it's ready. Then I what's next I have to do? Create a convert text, okay? Now, what will be the name of this convert text? It is for the active. Okay, then, okay, now here, what will be the active? If it trips, we will put here, okay, trip. Okay, so meaning if it is active, so signal equals to one. Okay, now let me create another new convert text. Okay, so this one for inactive. Inactive. Okay, now what will be the behavior? Inactive, normal. If there is no trip, it should display normal. Then signal equals to zero. Okay, now I will copy this so that I will not retype. Then paste it. Paste. Okay, now change the content. This one will be for the stroke. Okay. Now change the active. When it is active, now alarm should be in red color. Okay, so I will use red. Inactive. Okay, if it is inactive, I can use dark green. Okay. Now what else? Oh, one more thing. Okay, this one is for the flow. Okay, we're almost done. Okay, please bear with me. Okay, okay, flow. Okay, so what will be the next step? Create a convert text, then configure it. Active. What will be the flow? Okay, I can say on or flow. Okay, now I will just use the simple one. Signal equals one. I hope you already grasped all already the concept of what I'm doing. Okay. So inactive, okay, inactive. Now here, what will be, if there is no flow, then I can say off or no flow. It depends on you. You are the BMS engineer, you can always select. And of course, what you are doing will be checked and scrutinized by the consultant. If he will say, no, I don't like that one, it should display flow when there is flow or no flow, then you can change it here. Okay, now okay, now I have to copy this for the stroke. Copy stroke attribute, paste. Okay, now let's change this one first. Change the attribute, it should be the stroke. Okay, then change the active and inactive scenario. When it is active, I will use dark green. When it is inactive, I will use this dark gray. Okay, so I can save it. Once I save this, this one will go to our server, okay? So it will be saved. Let me see, maybe, okay, it should be saved here. Okay, it's already saved. Now, how are we going to test our graphics? So we need to test the graphics. Okay. Now, by the way, guys, here in my dynamic value, I don't need to do any convert value or convert text. Okay. So as is, it will just display whatever is the value being monitored in the field. Okay. Now, sir, Mr. Capellan, how I'm going to test the snippets or the values here? Okay. So how it will display from manual to auto, from off to on, from off to on, from normal to trip, from off to on, okay? Now here, we can test our graphics if it is responding correctly based on the signal. Now here, view, from view, you can go to test, okay? So test, then you can preview. Okay, so we will preview. Okay, this will be our graphics. Okay, now you have to watch here in this snippet. We have to see if it is changing based on the signal. Now, I will, let's say, pump one flow. Okay, now the value or the signal from device. Now, when you say value from device, let's say flow status. So we have a device like flow switch. Okay, see if the flow switch detected the flow, it will give us one signal. Okay, now let's say I will say one. Okay, Then enter. Okay, as you can see here, you see this one. Okay, maybe it's not this. It's changed to 75. Okay. Now here, as you can see, it changes to on when I receive a signal. From value from device or a signal from device, let's say the flow switch detected the flow, then it will become on. Okay, now let's see handoff auto status. Now what is the device here? The selector switch. Let's say someone put it in automatic pump one, so we will be receiving one signal. Okay, then as you can see it becomes auto. Okay, then what else? Run status from your differential pressure switch or flow switch, then I will say okay, run status. I already have it there. The run status becomes on. Okay, now start stop command. Let's say our control logic program issue the command to start it, so we will be getting one. Enter. Okay, as you can see it becomes on. Okay, now trip. Now let's say something happens in the pump. It trips. There is a high current, then it trips, then it will be one. Enter. Then as you can see, I have there trip. Okay. So let's say trip. Someone reset it, becomes zero. Okay, normal. Then start stop command. Remove by our control logic program. Okay, becomes off, run status. Of course, if it is off, no more run status. Then what else? Handoff auto. Let's say someone put it in manual or off. Okay, so that's it, guys. So based on the signal we are receiving from the device, like the field devices, we are be able to see the actual real-time value of the points that we are monitoring in our building management system. Okay, now I have flow here. Now let's change the flow to zero signal. So our flow switch did not receive or did not detect a flow, so it will be zero, so it will be off. Okay, so same thing you have to do in pump two, the same procedure. Okay, so guys, I think I have shown you already how the snippets like dynamic text will respond to different signal from the device in the field. Okay, so when the device give us one signal, so what will be the response of the snippets? If we receive a zero signal, what will be the response of the snippet? So by default, if all are zero, so this will be the default value. Manual, off, off, normal, off, then zero, because we don't have run hours. Okay, now guys, I think I have given you already the some idea how are you going to play or how are you going to test the response of your dynamic text snippets based on the signal being received from the field or from the field devices. Okay, so thank you for watching this short video clip, and I hope you are enjoying my series tutorial, especially to those who are interested in joining the field or the engineering field for building management system or building automation. Okay, now again, if you are new to my channel, you can always subscribe and you can always support my channel by watching, like, and you can share, and you can also enjoy whatever ads is being displayed in my channel. Okay, so thank you very much, and once again, Santos Capilian Jr. will always say God bless us all. And again, I'm not claiming any expertise, I'm just trying to share what I have learned. Actually guys, I did not receive a formal training in this software. I tried to learn it by myself. Okay, now I want to share it with you, especially those who are wishing to become a BMS engineer. And I do hope, if God is willing, I will be able to produce BMS engineer in my channel. So again, thank you and bye for now.